Welcome back to Jersey Matters. Millions were spent and debates got heated over the future of Airbnb and short-term rentals in Jersey City. And then Airbnb lost a stunning defeat at the ballot box. What does that mean now for Jersey City and for other cities? Our Sherry Karabin takes a look. Sherry.
Thank you, Larry. Many people list their properties on Airbnb to make some extra cash or even to help make ends meet. But soon, some Jersey City residents will no longer be able to do so. This after voters overwhelmingly approved a referendum to preserve new regulations on short-term rentals.
We had many calls to the police about one house on the block where there were constant parties, garbage, fights, undesirables.
From quality of life issues to a decreasing number of affordable rental units.
People are buying out whole buildings and it's allowing them to essentially become hotels. It's making the neighborhood also very expensive.
Those are a few of the problems Jersey City residents attribute to the rapid rise in Airbnb listings in the city. In November, voters greenlighted a referendum that will allow an ordinance to take effect, placing new restrictions on short-term rentals.
It required that Airbnbs be owner-occupied. That's a primary principle of what we were doing. And then it put some restrictions around renters, and it put restrictions around how many days a person who's not on premise could rent out their place. And the goal was to allow people to supplement their income using Airbnb, but at the same time protect neighborhoods.
The ordinance was first passed in June, but its fate hung in the balance after a referendum was placed on the ballot, giving voters the option of keeping the changes from taking effect. Airbnb reportedly devoted over $4 million to fighting off the new regulations. In a statement, Airbnb spokesperson Christopher Nolte expressed disappointment with the outcome, saying, quote, "From the start of this campaign, we knew this was going to be one of the toughest fights we faced, with the big New York hotel industry determined to fight home sharing, but we had an obligation to stand up for our community. It's unfortunate to see the hotel-backed special interests run a campaign that moves Jersey City in a different direction. Airbnb isn't the only organization disappointed by the outcome."
We stand for civil rights, and we want to make sure that everyone has the right to do with their property, to do whatever they want with their personal properties. So I don't think there should be any restriction.
Now, starting on January 1st, short-term rentals of properties where the owner-operator is not present are limited to no more than 60 nights per calendar year. Short-term rentals are prohibited in many multifamily buildings as well, and renters are banned from listing their homes altogether. Those who do qualify must register and pay for a permit, which has to be renewed annually. The NAACP president says the new rules hurt residents who are already struggling financially.
In Jersey City, the taxes are extremely high, and homeowners cannot afford to keep their properties. If they don't have augmented income, they may lose their properties. So it is helpful if they can have someone temporarily lease a portion of their home.
This law professor says while the 2015 agreement between the city and Airbnb was initially thought to be a win-win for everyone, things simply got out of control, with the number of listings going from hundreds to around 3,000 at the time of the referendum.
The situation went from one where there were people just renting out rooms in their house to make a little extra money to greedy developers, landlords coming in and buying up properties and taking them off the rental market to skirt, real estate or rent control regulations.
Kelly says the upcoming regulations are an attempt to remedy that problem as well as address quality of life and safety issues. He predicts other municipalities may follow Jersey City's example.
Jersey City had the largest number of Airbnb units, but you have a lot of other cities and towns in New Jersey, that are on the train line into Manhattan that are seeing growing numbers of Airbnb units, and they're going to be encountering the same complaints. And I think residents in those cities and towns are going to take notice of what happened in Jersey City.
Although the new rules are set to take effect on January 1st, a spokesperson from the mayor's office says residents are being given a year's grace period. Reporting from Jersey City, this is Sherry Karabin for Jersey Matters. Mm-hmm.